How many of you have seen this already? 15%. Okay, good. Good. It's working. How many of you are founders? How many of you are funded founders? How many of you are Series A founders? Good. This is very relevant for you. My wish is, by looking at this, 30% of you will shut down, or you will make your startup better, okay? So we'll talk about this quickly. Can you answer this question? All the guys who have seen this can ignore the first 10 minutes, but there is a lot more over here. How many of you can answer this question? Which goods and services were more efficient 10 years ago? Anybody wants to raise their hand and answer? Call centers should be more efficient? No. What used to happen? I'm saying, what was more efficient 10 years ago?
Print
India was more efficient 10 years ago? Media was more efficient 10 years ago? No. Then your story should not exist. What else? Sorry? I'm sorry, I'm not understanding it. Ramayana serial. This is what happens, Shraddha, when you charge too much. Okay, it's impossible to answer this question because all the efficient stuff is in future, and all the inefficient stuff is in the past. This is unique to humans, and the reason it's unique to humans is that if you ask a lion or a deer or a rabbit what was more efficient 10 years ago or what was more efficient, going to be efficient 10 years in future, they'll say, sab kuch same hi hai. They have to wait for evolution to kick in to become more efficient. It is not going to be by just existing, right? But humans are hacking evolution by being more efficient through the goods and services that you guys create and give to consumers, okay? But there is a unique situation. There are millions of lanes that the consumers are going through, and each lane could be, how do I upload pictures faster? How do I get fitter faster? How do I get to funding faster? How do I become more efficient in getting good marks in my exams? We can think of millions and millions of things between B2C and B2B problems that you can think that the humans are trying to get better at, right? And every time a human is in the previous state and you help them cross that state to become more efficient, you unlock pot of gold. Okay? So you help humanity move from state A, inefficiency, to more efficient state, that is state B, you unlock pot of gold. Right? Clear so far? Okay, good. We'll jump to understanding this a little bit further. How do you know that you're building a company that is going to unlock the pot of gold? Because so many of us build things and 99% of them fail. Right? My objective of building this theory was, if I can prevent, you know, startups used to come to me and ask me, sir, this is my idea, and I find it very hard to tell them this is bullshit. I'm sure you guys meet startup founders and you kind of find it very hard to tell them this is not going to work. So I thought, let's create a framework where you can do self-assessment, right, to know if it's going to work or create wealth or destroy wealth. When I say destroying wealth, you will lose money, time, years, whatever you want to call that. Let's understand this. What is the efficiency score out of 10 for booking a railway ticket at a railway platform versus IRCTC? A is 10. No, 10 is the highest score, 1 is the lowest score. So anybody wants to give a score? 2 and 8. 3 and 8. 3 and 7. 2 and 8. Okay, cool. Shraddha, you're giving 2 scores. Every time you will see that this is a kind of a score you'll get on an average, and every time the delta of efficiency is greater than 4, you unlock pot of gold. Therefore, we'll call this the delta 4 theory, and we'll go deep diving into it. Making sense so far? Now we'll see more examples. But before we jump there, let's just talk about three traits of Delta 4 behavior. It is irreversible. Anybody who's tried IRCTC has gone back to railway station and booked ticket, please raise your hand. Sir, aap to kamal ho. Have you tried IRCTC? Okay. Jana padta tha. Okay. It is very hard to move back. There'll be some strong reasons. For example, how many of you have booked an Meru after trying Uber and Ola? The same thing. And I can give multiple examples around this. How many of you have a digital camera after owning a smartphone? And you'll see many such examples, not DSLR and all these fancy cameras, regular digital cameras, right? They just disappeared, right? There is UBP versus USP. Ramesh talked about cool, but cool is very hard to, it's very vague. UBP is a very interesting thing. UBP, everybody understand what's USP over here? All right, good. If you don't know, that's on Google. This is not on Google. UBP is unique brag-worthy proposition. Okay? Let me ask you guys a question. How many of you use Truecaller? Raise your hand. How many of you downloaded Truecaller because you saw an ad of Truecaller? Not a single person. I'll tell you how you found out about it. Somebody came to you and said, let me show you a cool app. Tell me any number, I'll give you the name of the person. Or let me show you, abhi kisi ka phone aayega, dekho, naam dikh jata hai. Right? And then you immediately downloaded the app. That's unique brag-worthy proposition, right? Any product that has Delta 4 has unique brag-worthy proposition because everybody who moves to state B, which is the more efficient state, screams at everybody at this inefficient state guy and says, kya kar raha hai, boss? Idhar aa jao. Somebody says, I don't know who's calling. Are like, boss, kya kar rahe ho? Kuch lete kyun nahi? Right? And that's why Truecaller download happens, right? And there is also high tolerance. I'll explain this. How many of you have faced problems with IRCTC? How many of you have still gone back to railway station after facing problems with IRCTC? Nobody. Why? Because it builds high tolerance when you have a Delta 4, right? So this is, if you don't have a startup that is Delta 4, it's going to be very hard to create wealth. Let's take an example, buying shirts offline and buying shirts online. Can any four or five of you can tell me different scores, efficiency score out of 10 for buying shirts offline and buying shirts online? 8 and 3? 6 and 4? 8 and 5? 5-5. Okay. You see different scores, which is kind of looking like this. 3-6, 5-5, 6-4. It's not Delta 4. Do you agree? Whenever you don't have Delta 4, you do not unlock pot of gold, right? And that's because the current experience, everybody will know, oh, fitting ka problem hai, oh, I don't really understand the fabric, I like certain things. In fact, I'll tell you what people do to increase the Delta 4. They'll do cashbacks and discounts and artificially increase the new behaviors Delta. And that does not last, right? Because you cannot forever sustain discounts and cashbacks. And therefore, this kind of a startup is reversible. One bad experience on buying shirts online, boss, I'm not buying this again. This is nonsense. No UBP, nobody brags about things that are not brag-worthy, right? Think about all your own social media. Whatever you have shared, you always knew in your mind, ispe kitna likes milega. You tell yourself, oh, this people will appreciate. This photograph of mine, I'm going to get at least 100 likes. This article that I'm sharing is going to be shared by more people. This is amazing. I'm going to share a witty comment. I'm going to steal somebody's original comment and put it on there, and I'll get 50 more likes, right? But the thing is about low tolerance, because we talked about sort of reversal behavior, and that results in either wealth not being created or being erosion. I'll give you examples of another thing. For example, laundry startups, right? I know at least like 80-100 companies were into the laundry startup business, right? But I'll tell you, whenever you have inefficiency of not being able to wash your own clothes and you manage to get some more income, the more efficient way of getting your laundry is getting a maid. That is Delta 4, not going to a laundry app, right? This is why we see multiple times companies getting created because we copy the concepts from the West where you cannot hire a maid. Why? Because sometimes a maid costs as much as your salary when you're starting up in there. Do you know that, right? In US? Okay. Therefore, you have to say, I'll wash my clothes on my own or I'll use a laundry app. But when we go into this kind of a thing where we say, oh, cool, we'll copy this idea from the West, which most of us do, we don't create a value addition for the Indian consumer because we don't create a Delta 4 product, right? So therefore, it ends up in erosion of value. And let's say if a company gets funded with a low Delta, all of you know what I'm talking about over here. You've seen it. Some of you have used the discounts, knowing the fact that as soon as the discounts are over, I'm not going to use it anyways, right? That's because the product was inherently low Delta. Let's say you are seeing all these massive discounts on cabs right now or recharges right now. Will you go back to a shop or will you go back to the old cab behavior after discounts ends? No. So discounts are used in Delta 4 categories to gain market share. In Delta 1 category, it just erodes value. Now, we'll talk about things where Delta 4 is not good enough, right? I will talk about six points over here. Affordability. Flights are Delta 4. Trains are not compared to that. But not if everybody could afford, how many of you will still go take a train if you can afford a flight every day? Nobody. Oh, you will still go to train? Why? Experience. Readiness. If I create an Uber-like app and nobody has got smartphones in this country, will it work? No, it will not. Learning effort. English is not the most efficient language. It's been there for hundreds and hundreds of years. But you don't move to an efficient language because somebody has taken the learning effort of learning 200,000, 3,000, 4,000 words and the grammar around it. So even if a Delta 4 language comes about, which is more efficient, I will not move to that, right? Same is true for Tally. How many CAs have got trained on Tally? Or SAP, right? Configurations. Domestic maid is a classic example. You will see that your mom will be very upset the maid when the maid doesn't come. And more upset when she decides to leave. Because she's done this 1,000 micro configurations on the maid. Ye idhar rakhna hai, ye aisa karne ke baad aisa karna hai, and all that stuff. These are micro configurations that you've done on a person. And therefore, even if you find a Delta 4 maid, you will not want to move because of the micro configurations or investments you made on that person, right? Collective participation. When the delta of the new behavior increases by the participation of humanity, for example, WhatsApp or sharing a phone number, right? It is hard to create a better product and still move people, right? And we'll talk about that in a little bit further. Branded lanes and verbs. Whenever the state is changing from A to B and it becomes branded, acha ye Google karlo, Xerox karlo. Creating a Delta 4 is hard because we are not saying, let's look up. We are saying, let's Google, let's WhatsApp, and so on and so forth. Whenever the state change becomes a verb, it's very hard to beat this. Okay? Can low Delta 4 fake Delta 4, and can you hack UBP? And we'll talk about this through three examples. Is iOS Delta 4 to Android? Please raise your hand. Okay, one person. Okay. Is Android Delta 4 to iOS? Please raise your hand. Okay, three people feel. Are you all engineers? Great. Is Patanjali Delta 4 to other Unilever products? Please raise your hand. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, good, great. Is BMW Delta 4 to other cars? Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6 people. Right? You know, a lot of you are just doubting yourself and raising your hand because a lot of other people are not raising hands, and I'll tell you why. Because you feel it is Delta 4, it's not Delta 4. So brands can do this cool stuff, which the previous session talked about, and make things Delta IV, and this is how it's done. This is what happens when there is no new innovation possible, then you kind of create this cool thing. When autonomous cars come, a Delta IV self-driving car will not be able to beat it because it's cool to go in autonomous cars, right? And therefore, it is hard to, you can fake Delta IV by the power of marketing and branding. It feels, how many of you feel that your religion is Delta IV compared to other religions? Please raise your hand. Anybody wants to raise their hand? Okay, one guy, okay. This is because you feel it is Delta IV. It is not. In fact, it's all the same. Therefore, you will see that you can do Delta IV hacking by three things. You can use influencers. I'll give you a small example. Let's say I create a great software for pharma companies which will make their sales force more efficient, right? And I sell to pharma company number one, I sell to pharma company number two, and Shraddha sells her software, which is exactly the same software, largely, to pharma company number 38 because she knows that person. I took 9 months to convince pharma two company, and she gets the business in like two meetings, right? Now we both go to pharma company number six. Who is she going to buy from, me or Shraddha? Who? Shraddha, you work for her. Yes. That's a bad hack. Most people will buy from anybody who sold to pharma two, right? Because we copy the influencers, right? We don't copy somebody who's lower than us in status, correct? All of you agree on that point? Good. So influencers is a great hack to show that this is the greatest place to be, right? It works for this. Look at the sponsors over here, right? Now the fifth guy who came here must have seen, ye char log kar rahe, achha hi hoga. I'm sorry. But nobody knows who's the fifth guy, okay? You can piggyback another Delta IV. And a small example is that if you have built a Delta IV product, let's say, which is applicable for everybody who wears specs, right? And let's say you built a great liquid which does not prevent, I mean, it prevents fogging of the glasses that is happening for me right now. Now, it's great to piggyback and sample that product with everybody who sells glasses. Glasses is Delta IV compared to people who cannot see without glasses, correct? Till something else comes along, correct? And when the LASIK surgery does not feel as scary and comes for 3,000 rupees, nobody will wear specs, correct? Fake inefficiencies. FMCG companies are brilliant at creating faking inefficiencies. Nobody cared about dandruff 50 years ago. Nobody cared about wrinkles 100 years ago. Their ad will say, aapke shirt pe dandruff hai. Like, hey, look at this person. This actor does not have dandruff. Please use this shampoo. You can fake inefficiencies as well, right? And that's what the brilliant marketeers do. They don't fight in same Delta products. They'll create their own highway, which is, oh, you have this problem. Oh, you are losing hair. Take my oil. Your hair is of different color. Oh, it's thinning. Take this. Nobody cared about these things. Nobody like took daily bath 300 years ago. But we create these inefficiencies. I'm not kidding. This is history. You should check it out. But a lot of people tell me that, Kunal, it's very easy. Delta IV to piche dekhke sabko malum padta hai. No, the famous quote is, after the Titanic sank, everybody knew how it could have been saved. Is it true? So we'll test this. How many of you use this product? Downloaded this product? How many of you feel this is Delta IV? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. How many of you are still telling your family members to use Ola or Uber? Great, all of you. It's been 3-year-old service. But we are still bragging about it. That's the beauty about Delta IV products. We want the entire humanity to move from the old behavior to new behavior. Okay? Good. So, I don't have more examples because I am not tuned in, But you can think about your own startup. And I'll tell you, a lot of times, because you built your own idea, you will not be able to say honesty to yourself. Ask 5 founders and tell them, please don't sugarcoat. Tell me the true Delta 4 score that you think, have I'm achieving it or not achieving it. Don't ask friends and family. Why shouldn't you ask friends and family? In India, we are factories of sugarcoating. We don't tell bad things in front of the person. We say, as soon as the person has gone out of the room. How to measure Delta on new ideas? I will talk about free charge, because I could not find a better way of explaining this. When I started free charge, in 2007 years ago, I created this screenshot in Visio. And I took it to all these brands that you can see over here. And I took it to all the operators that were listed on the top and showed this to them. And I asked consumers of all income levels, would you use something like this where if you recharge, you get equal value coupons of different retailers of these brands? Only when 95% of people said yes, we started building the product. The problem, by the way, I'm a philosophy graduate. I'm not an engineer. I have seen people who are engineers start coding first. Never speak to consumers because consumers ko kya malum hai. Steve Jobs told me consumers don't know anything. That's only true for Steve Jobs. If I could take the effort of building something as real as this, and this was built in Visio with hand, and showed to people, and I pulled it out today to explain this, because people were asking me, how do you create Delta 4, measure kaise karoge? Basically, you create a prototype which is not coded, just take a printout of that, or put it on a slide, and show it to stakeholders. Only when everybody feels excited about it, you start building that. Because what happens is when we build something first, we fall in love with it. And everybody knows love is blind. Great. We get into confirmation bias that we start loving our idea. How many of you feel that person you love is Delta 4? Guys, you should be raising your hands. They can see you on video. They can see you on video. But we feel that time that that person is Delta 4. And that is the beauty about feeling Delta 4. You're laughing extra. It happened multiple times for you. What I'm saying is that when you are giving up your life, your years, your investors' money, your own money, the 5 people that you've hired, you have a basic responsibility to try, right? India has become this, we use this word from the West, which says fail fast. No, plan better. You can, it's possible. You know, imagine, like, I'm making a cricket reference over here, so pardon me for that. Like, imagine we are all trying to, we cannot see the ball, we are playing in dark, and we are trying to hit a sixer out of every ball, and the ball can be coming fast, slow, on the ground, doesn't matter. We're just trying to hit 6 every time. And I'll tell you what happens. When you don't time it, it just goes to the stump. The beauty is when you can find a fast ball and just deflect it to the boundary. The fast ball is a Delta 4 solution. Don't try to do these crazy things. I have seen no mediocre founders do extraordinarily well with Delta 4 spaces versus great founders working on Delta 1 ideas and losing. And I'll tell you who makes money when you have Delta 1 companies. Who makes money when 2 Delta 1 companies compete? Anybody can guess? Google. Think about it. Because a Delta 4 company does not need, how many of you downloaded Truecaller because of Google Ads? Nobody. I'll tell you who makes money out of Delta 1 things again. Employees. They'll say, sir, idhar to itna offer mil raha hai. Okay. A Delta 4 company does not struggle. In fact, they make people take salary cuts. Okay? You will see many people, their greatest business is Delta 4 because they make Delta 1 companies compete. Because they think they are cool, but they are not. Coming to the last part of the presentation, how do you find hidden inefficiencies to solve? One problem I have with the entrepreneurs is, they tell me the problem I'm trying to solve is, I think it is limiting. You should be saying that the inefficiency I'm going after. Problems are subsets of inefficiencies, right? And how do you do that? This is like the metal detector that you see in the US. I observed that in the US. They used to go on the beach and keep searching for metal, and once in a while, they would find gold. What I have observed in my personal thing on finding inefficiencies is, every time somebody who's come from an efficient country to our country and lived here for 3-4 years, or 1-2 years, at least in the first year, they are the best people to ask, what do you find inefficient about this country? And they'll tell you 100 things. And out of that 100 things, 80 things, nobody is solving. No competition. But we don't do that because we are not designed to think this way. Right? And therefore, it is extremely hard to create wealth versus just following the basic framework of Delta 4. So this is going to be my last slide.
Are you trying to say that a Delta 4 is almost like a winner-take-it-all in a market?
No. When somebody discovers a Delta 4, they start building it, unless they gain market share completely or they create massive network effects, right? For example, a WhatsApp has created network effects, which is related in WhatsApp groups and so many other social behavior, which is a collective participation. That's like a winner-take-all, right? But there is no social behavior in, let's say, a cab aggregator thing, and therefore they compete, but they're competing for market share against the other behavior, which is the other inefficient behavior, right? So it is a much better fight than trying to find something that is not a problem at all. Cool.
Hi, Kunal. I'm Agam. Actually, what you said that you have to ask a guy who came from the developed country to give us the inefficiency what our company have. So according to you, which are the sectors which we leads to identify inefficiency and sort it out?
India is the national world capital of inefficiencies.
No, but in specifically which needs to be attended as soon as possible, right?
So the way you find out is that is it hurting people and it's making companies not compete or humans not compete well enough to win, right? Let's say, are they wasting too much time on it? Are they wasting too much money on it? And so on and so forth, right? Is there a way, for example, I met a company yesterday, which can, it's an AI company which can do medical tests, which takes 2 days in 10 seconds, right? Now, if they can do a 99% more accuracy, or close to human accuracy on doing that blood test, then they have made a Delta 4 product. Understood?
Hi.
One last question.
Kunal, I'm Shaik here. Yes, it looks
okay.
Right.
Go ahead.
So your Delta 4 sounds really close to the Blue Ocean Theory. So what I wanted to ask...
I don't know about it. Please tell me more about it.
I think we'll discuss this separately.
Okay.
But what I wanted to ask you is, you did not explain to us how you convert a Delta 1 to a Delta 4, because there is inherent efficiencies in the model itself. So, I mean, I'm not talking about your model. I'm saying in the Delta 1 model itself. So how do you convert it? There needs to be a strategy paradigm there to convert it.
Yeah, so there are two things. It's a great question. The question, I'll repeat it, he's saying that if you have a Delta 1 solution, how do you convert into a Delta 4 solution? There is a great possibility that you will not be able to make it Delta 4 because of the fundamental assumptions that you've taken, right? And therefore, sometimes it's good to shut it down. In this country, we have not been trained to shut things down. Yesterday, somebody wrote to me on Facebook, Kunal, under which desperate circumstances you had to sell your company? And I'm like, that's not the only time companies are sold, right? Sometimes you can create great outcomes and you exit the company as well. But the thing is, in India, we have we treat our companies like our kids or our spouses, which we are saying, "Arey, isko kaise chhode? Abhi to humne create kiya tha." Which is not the way you think about it. You have to sometimes kill it. Sometimes you can say, "What am I wrong in my assumption fundamentally, right? And can I go back to the drawing board and say?" And one method I use is that I ask, let's say, a sales guy in the team, and call him and say, "If you had a magic wand, and also you were made the CEO of the company, what are the two things you will do to the product that will create the queue of customers outside the office versus you having to go and sell?" Mm-hmm. And they usually come up with very good ideas. If they cannot come up with good ideas, then you are fundamentally flawed. So according to me, any place which has large sales teams is selling a Delta One product through the Delta Four efficiency of distribution.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Kunal.
Okay, I'll take the last question. I'm out of time. Question.
Okay, Kunal, thanks a lot for putting it very technically in a very proper way. And I'm very indebted to Shraddha for bringing you and bridging you out with us. The question, and it's not a question, but I want to ask you, this Delta 4 theory is well documented, or what we can, I'm very much interested into knowing it further. So where I can read it more about it.
Look at him.
Or it is okay, your
wait,
own.
Wait, look at Kunal Shah smiling so happily.
This is the latest version of this that you've seen so far. It's okay. Work in progress. More questions I get asked, I'm evolving it further because this is something that is my curiosity as well.
Oh, wonderful.
I'm not a professor. I just find...
You don't have the title, but you are a professor.
Thank you. For me, I feel very bad when founders give their entire life, they are so smart and they don't become successful. So my objective of creating this was, even if I can make 5,000 companies shut down, I'll be very happy.
Wonderful. And basically, right. Kunal, the Biyani spoke before you here, the Future Group and Shraddhan, he also put it, but the way you have put it into the words, he also calculated that this much percent is required here and where, and that's why the e-commerce module will not work. That is also his Delta 4 calculations onto this one.
Yeah.
But the way you have put it is really wonderful. I want it to be in a book form.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Facebook is better than book. Delta 4. Thank you.
Growth is definitely scaling up, expanding a company's customer base. So trying to reach out, get more customers on board. But while one does that, one is also looking at their brand or the promise.
We think that the founders that are coming today are much stronger. The quality of the founders is much higher. Because about 5 years ago, many of the founders had experience, let's say on the tech side, with Google R&D, Microsoft R&D. Today they're coming out from they have startup experience, right? X Flipkart, X Ola, X Snapdeal. They've seen product launches, they've seen product failures also.